I do have to say something before I sing this song, and I hope I have enough energy to sing it. When April and I and Silas walked into this church, I hate to compare. And I don't like to compare, but we found that this church was genuine. The blessings, the worshiping, the praising was just real. I don't like to go to a church where big giants, TV screens, everybody wearing big giant diamond rings. You worship for a minute. You got security guards, bodyguards. It just doesn't seem right. My bodyguard is the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We don't need security here. Our security is right here with the Lord Jesus Christ.
Right.
This is the house of the Lord. And I appreciate that, Pastor. I really do. I really appreciate coming to this church. It's just awesome. You may have 50 people, but it's a lot better than 10,000 people not doing their job. I had a dilemma a few months ago. This is my testimony. A few months ago, I had a dilemma where I was trapped. Joe, the devil had me wrapped up. He had my legs wrapped up, both legs just tied down. He worked his way up into my stomach, into my heart. My heart was cold. He worked his way to my right arm, turned right-handed. He locked it up. Now I'm trapped. He had my mind just all changed around. Everything was confusing to me. But I still had my left hand. And this hand right here picked that phone up one day. And he called us, Pastor. Pastor came to visit with his wife. And he had us sit down and we talked. Yet my heart was cold, my eyes were just cold. And as my wife sat in one corner and I sat in the other corner, and the pastor was talking, his wife was talking, trying to give me some insight. I'm trying to battle. I'm battling left and right. Inside of me, I'm battling. And the pastor, with his nice, humble, beautiful smile, said his words. And then his wife said some words. And she looked at me with that look like, how dare you? And I caught it. I understood real well. I said, I have a lady who I'm hurting. I have a pastor who's coming here to my house, giving me some insights and information. I have his wife also who's trying to help me. And here I'm still back. But after we talked and so on, that look that I got was enough for me to say, I better wake up. And so ever since that day, the Lord has put a lot of great things in my life. My heart is fresh again, my mind, and I'm not lying down no more. I'm free. The Lord has freed me, and through Him is just the grace of God. Awesome. So then, came with prayers, and it worked out. However, I have one more dilemma, Pastor. And just to let you know, that pastor and that first lady is Pastor Keller and his wife. They did a lot for us, and we appreciate that. However, I have one more dilemma. Last week, you paying attention, Pastor. Last week, we prayed for the children. We laid our hands on children. Even parents, even people who don't have children, laid hands on children. It was awesome. It was touching. And what I see here across the church, I see many, many kids here. And they're all seriously worshiping. It's beautiful. See this. But I have one dilemma, and I ask you children today of God, and those who are older. I have a son named Silas, as you know. And Silas is more to himself. My dilemma is this. I have a brother, two brothers, one in Carolina, one in here in Grand Rapids, assistant Grand Rapids, assistant Philadelphia, mom and dad, cousins, so on and so on. My son and my wife and our kids. Yeah, we don't pray to God. We don't pray. Nighttime could come around, you can go to sleep. I go to sleep. We don't pray. We can have a meal together. We forget who God is. We don't pray. So today I ask you, children of God, to extend your hands over us so that we could pray together. And I'm assuming that most of your parents here are praying with you guys at nighttime, daytime, throughout the week. I'm assuming that. But I'm not doing that. I have to admit that. I lack that. But I want it. So I ask you to help me out. Help us out. Getting back to that prayer. Talking to the Lord. Worshiping Him. Praising Him. Because it is the best thing you can do. It is so great to have that. I will continue to sing this song here right now if I can, and please pray for our church.
Living rain is coming down, is coming nearer to this old town. Risen for weak and strong, if given in mercy, it won't be long. Living rain is coming down, it's coming closer to the Lord. Tears of joy and tears of shame, oh, watch forever in Jesus' name. And healing rain, it comes with fire, so let it fall and take the rest. And healing rain, I'm not afraid to be one in the heaven's name. Lift your heads, let us return to the mercy seat with time together. In your eyes, and only you, the Son of Man, can take the heart and let it expand. So lift your hands, they can be held by someone greater than the great I am. And healing rain, it comes with fire, so let it fall and take us higher. Healing rain, I'm not ashamed to be the one in heaven. To be the one. Rain, rain, rain. rain, rain.